Commodities as a space is something that also seen equal amount of downside, even though some of them have been looking pretty steady. Let's bring in our experts to talk about it. We have Hitesh Jain, research analyst at IIFL. We also have Nitin Nachnani joining us, research analyst at Geojit Comtrade. And we have our first caller with us. Chetan is with us from Bangalore. Chetan, what's your question?
Good afternoon. Yeah, I have around 10 kgs of silver, around 56,000. And I have a gold of half a kilo of gold, around 27. So I just want to know what will be the future of this both commodities. Sure, I can hold it for up to 1 hour, between 1 to 3 months of range. So could you please advise me, and what is this both commodities heading towards?
Right. Hitesh, what's your response to Chetan's query?
Starting with silver, I believe that the client has actually bought silver at a resistance level, which is 56,000 itself. And the support, which we believe is near-term support, is at 54,500. What we advocate is the client to basically exit the position on any bounce due to weaker rupee. The position should be exited or liquidated close to 56,000 levels, because any substantial upside is not seen in silver prices, taking into consideration that silver is also an industrial metal. Apart from being a precious metal, silver also derive cues from the tone in the industrial commodities, and the tone in copper and other industrial commodities on the weaker side. So it is suggested that the client should exit position at close to 56,000 levels.
Nitin, what about you? What's your response to Chetan's query?
I agree to what Hardik says. Like, silver basically is in a primary downtrend. Currently, we are seeing silver is trading between 53,500 and 58,500 on the upper side. Rightly said by Hardik, like 56,000 is a strong resistance level. We believe that the prices will not breach this level, and we do expect that the prices will correct downwards as the primary trend is down. So keeping this view in mind, we expect a small bounce to happen in silver, which can come up to 55,500 levels. This would be a good level where the investor should exit from his long position and book the small losses which he is facing.
Let's bring in our next caller. We have Shashank joining us right now from Mumbai. Okay, it's an SMS that we have from Shashank. Holds one lot of crude oil. He's actually short sold one lot of crude oil at 4965, wants to know what he should expect right now. Nitin, first to you, what's your opinion on Shashank's query, what he should do right now?
Right, in case of crude, the primary trend for crude is up, the intermediate trend for crude is also up, but in the short term we are observing some correction in crude. Going forward, the crude has an immediate support at 4970 levels. So if we breach that levels, we expect prices to go up to 4850 levels. So currently what I think is he should hold on to his position, but if the prices closes about 5070 level, the short term trend which was down will again turn up. So what I suggest is he should hold his position with a stop loss of 5070, and I expect a target of 4850 to happen if we breach the levels of 4970 levels.
All right. And Hitesh, what about you?
Yeah, I endorse the same views. Actually, the near-term trade in crude oil is absolutely on the lower side. And we have witnessed in the past few days that crude has breaching after $100, also again bounces back to the $96-$95 levels. On the MCX front, we believe that the support lies at 4970-4980. Still, till that those positions, the gentleman can hold short positions, and if it breaches 4930, one can trigger fresh shots also.
All right, Hitesh and Nitin, thank you so much for your time, gentlemen. We'll have to wrap it at that. Thank you so much for your time. Great chatting with you.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.